some days I just get luckier than others. I just got off of work for my day job and went outside and checked the mail, and it was a busy day today. And what do I find waiting in my mailbox? This potted motor from Lori in Minnesota. So I think it's Minnesota. Yeah, Sanborn, Minnesota. Anyway, Lori, you're one lucky person, because I've got nothing to do right now. So this thing literally just came in the house. So I'm going to be able to turn this around like almost instantaneously. I'm too tired to go into doing other stuff, and a motor rewire is perfect for me right at the moment. Anyway, let's see what we got. Well, the wire is definitely shot. You can see how the wire is all perished here. The insulation is all crumbly. It is garbage, as they say. So we'll just strip this one down, clean her up real nice, rewire her, test her. You know, sometimes I check the motors before I rewire them. But when I see insulation that's crumbly like that, I don't need to test that. I know that that's going to be in bad shape. So, I don't even bother. So, let's get this apart. Oh, come on. Lori pulled her bobbin winder off of this. So, I don't even have a bobbin winder to work on. It's like, she's like, here, Bob, take an easy one. So. Be more than happy to do it. All right, let's push the moving. This is the true key right here as to how bad it's going to be. Oh, that's nice and nasty. And did the washers come with that? Or did the washer stay in the machine, in the motor? Oh! You know, I didn't pull the brush caps off. We'll clean it all up anyway. Does not matter. Does not matter. You know, I was looking at another YouTube channel when I was having my coffee this morning. And on that one, I'm not mentioning any names, he was replacing the grease wicks. And I thought it was kind of amusing because he was wearing gloves. And I'm like, I haven't worn gloves working on a motor in forever. But then again, my hands are permanently stained with crud. So let's get the clips out. Oh yeah, nice and nasty. We're gonna clean all this schmoo up. Where did I put my roll of paper towels? Here it is. I almost couldn't find my paper towels. There we go. Smell that schmoo off of there. And let's see what we got. I wanna see if I can get that plastic washer extracted from here so I don't lose it. Come on. Behave. You know, I'm working around those armatures, those field coil wires. No sense in that. Pull it all apart. And I'm not even going to bother to try to pull that out. Snip that off. And alright. A little wrap. There we go. Thank you. and pull out the brass tubes. Oopsie. That out of the way. Extract these nasty wires. There we go. Now before I take this to the sink, now I'm going to get this washer off of here. Because I don't want to lose this down the sink. And surface tension is what's holding that in place at the moment. Let me try a finer pair of tweezers. There we go. Got it. That's a very, very fine, thin washer. Make sure there's only one. Only one. All right. Let's get... Oh, and the grommet is completely perished. Cut that out. Push the carcass out the back, right into the trashola. And nothing else on this is going to come off, except we're going to take some of the crud out of those grease ports so it doesn't wind up going down my sink. Because I'm married. That didn't sound good. Well, not that I'm married doesn't sound any good. I made it sound like Liz would yell at me. She doesn't. I yell at her. She yells at me for completely different reasons. Never once for grease in the kitchen sink. Hair in the bathroom sink, that's another story. Oh, look at that. Nice schmoo. Nice schmoo. Look at that. Isn't that delicious? Said nobody ever. Get all this crud. It is Friday. Sunday morning quickies has been shot already and edited. I actually got that done on Tuesday this week. And it's been sitting posted on YouTube, just hasn't been released yet. And I'll tell you right now, it's not really for the faint of heart. I might have made it look a little too easy, but I'm not going to release the subject just yet. Just saying, I almost changed my mind about releasing the video, but I decided, nope, I'm going to release it anyway. And because it's actually a lot of fun, but I'm not sure too many people are going to be able to do what I'm suggesting. It might be a little, I might have made it look a little too easy, is what I'm saying. But you won't know that until you see it. Well, it gets released, even though it's Sunday morning quickies, it's actually scheduled for release at 10 o'clock Eastern time in the evening on Saturday the 15th. That's when it's going to get released. And I release it early because I have friends out on the other side of the international dateline that if I release it Sunday morning, they don't get to see it until much, much later. And you know who you are, Megan Mills. That's why I release my Sunday morning quickies videos as early as I do, is for Megan. Specifically for Megan and her husband, Clark. But, anyway, alright, that's most of the heavy turd-like crap that's going to come out of this. So I'm going to take this, the worm, let me get the grease clips, and let me wipe some of the crap out of the grease clips as well. De-schmooify the grease clips a little bit. And we'll get through with that. We'll take the grease clip and get the other one here. Well, that one came out pretty clean on its lonesome. All right, we'll take this stuff to the sink. Hot water and Dawn. and I'll be back in a few minutes and we'll continue the march with the rewire of the Singer potted motor. We are back, ladies and gentlemen, and we have a clean body, so we're going to put that aside. I'm going to tackle the moving mass in a second. This stuff is cleaned up. So, we're next going to attack this wiring, which, as you can see, is in pretty, pretty sad shape. So, you know what I'm going to do first? I'm going to readjust this camera position, and hopefully I can get a better shot on this for you. Okay, pulling out a soldering gun once again. I'm getting lazy and I've been using my gun a lot. If I ever get around to cleaning my bench off, which, quite honestly, I could have been doing this afternoon instead of rewiring this motor. I just didn't feel like it. But when I actually get around to cleaning my bench off, I'm going to keep my soldering station permanently on the bench, and that's going to force me to keep my bench a little cleaner. All right. Now, this wire still got a little bit of, it's still slightly pliable. So like I demonstrated once in the past, at least I think I did recently, I'm going to take a pair of needle nose pliers and I'm going to grip lower down and I'm going to just try to break this insulation a little bit and pull it off. And I'm holding it further down so I don't damage the coils. And believe me, I've gotten these things back where somebody tried stripping the wire, didn't strip it properly, and pulled this wire right out of the coil. So I've got one strip back. I'm going to twist this up into a mass. I'm going to leave it alone, but it's twisted into a mass. Now we're going to tackle this one. We'll use the strippers to break it free a little bit. Pull this back a bit. That's way too much. Get some of that gone. And we'll, now that we have that free, boom. All right, is that going to be, no, I want to take that a little bit further back, believe it or not. So I don't want that so close. That'll be better. I don't want that so close to where it's going to be exiting the body of the motor. So we'll just twist this up. Notice this is way longer than what we're going to be using, but I figure if I've got the meat here to attach to, I can get all my wire wrapping, push it on down, trim everything up. Well, you'll see. It's going to be nice and neat when I'm done. Fear not. All right, let me dig into my wire supply. I had a little travesty with my wire supply earlier in the week, or last weekend, I guess it was. Part of the spool broke off, and I had to unspool a good portion of my spool of 18 gauge wire, which is, I think this is a 500 foot roll, something like that. Yeah, it's a 500 foot roll. I had to unspool a lot of it, which kind of upset me a little bit, but no big deal. All right. Once again, I'm going to strip this nice and long. As you'll see, bada bing, bada boom, nice long strip. Twist it all nice and tight. We'll start on this one. And you see how I'm holding it out, and I'm going to wrap that tightly around and keep those coils tight together as well, or as tight together as I can. Keep on wrapping. Okay. Nice and tight. We have a long turd coming off the end of that. Nothing to worry about. Never fear. So, we'll get some heat applied to the joint. Actually, let me clean this tip a little bit. hot, apply some solder, make sure the solder flows. Okay, solder has flowed. We will clip this off. And the wire is considerably longer than we need. I know you can't see this, but I'm reaching up to grab my supply of heat shrink. And we will slip a piece of heat shrink over that. It goes way back. And we will engage. Oh, it didn't light up. Do I need to put more butane on that? There we go. And it is shrinking. I think I need to reload the butane in this thing. Let me reload this real quick. Much better. Got some heat this time. There we go. This is not the most economical way of putting heat on something, but I've come to really like this little butane-powered heat gun. All right, that's the first one. Let's do the other side. Second verse, same as the first. There we go. And we'll get that nice and tight. And once again, lather, rinse, repeat. Lay that up alongside. I'm just going to wrap this tightly. Okay. That's good. Get that wire out of the way. And once again, let's get some heat going. By the way, somebody sent me a text message, not a text message, an email the other day asking about the tattoos I have on my arms and how many tattoos I've got. Well, there's a couple that you see regularly in these videos. There's one on my right hand, which is a curved flaming arrow. And the significance of that is that is my throttle hand for motorcycling. So if you turn it in the direction of the arrow, that makes things go fast. Which, yeah, it's cheesy, but that's what it is. And there was a time when motorcycling was an extremely important part of my life. I just can't do it now. And on the same arm, they asked about the rose that I have, and they can't quite make out what the text is on that. And the rose is for a family member. The text says on the top, in memory of SFC, that's Sergeant First Class Daniel Charles Fowler, KIA 428, 1967, Pleiku, RVN, Republic of Vietnam. That was my cousin Danny, who was a platoon sergeant with the 4th Infantry Division when he was killed in Nam in 67. So anyway, that's what the tattoos are for the people who have asked. And then on my left arm, a lot of people have said they've recognized Rat Fink. And people who didn't understand Rat Fink said, why do you have a mouse on your arm? And all I can say is, I'm not going to explain Rat Fink. I want you to Google it if you don't know what it is. Because it was a large part of my growing up. Let's put it that way. And then I've got a couple that you can't see that are higher up. You see part of one. You see the bottom end of a shield on my right arm up here, which is for the Berlin Brigade. And one that never shows up is on my upper left shoulder. That's a family thing. But so that's what the ink is. I hope that answers the questions. All right, now we've got, you're gonna need a grommet. I just dropped out of my container. So we will stick it out of the grommet. I don't need the soldering iron anymore. So let me get this out of my way. Soldering gun down. It's one of the reasons why I like using the gun is it's so much faster than the iron is. So I can get it out of my way that much sooner. So, move the coils over, stick the grommet vomit into the casting. These are such a joy to get in, by the way. And looks like it's in the hole. It's pretty close to in the hole. Let's finish it the rest of the way in here. Swing it around a screwdriver, that'll push it in, and now it's neatly in the hole. Okay. But before we go that far, I need some wider, and it's going to be off of a new spool, because this spool is empty. Oh, wow. Okay. I didn't realize I had run one dry. Okay. Clip this. And I'm going to want about there. So we're going to slide some 3/16 inch tubing over our two pieces of 18 gauge wire that has been slobbered in place and has its other shrink tubing on. We'll slide it all the way on down. Ta-da! And when we shrink this, this is going to replicate the look of the stuff that Singer used originally. It's going to be that, it's going to look like a flat two conductor wire. Assuming I did this right. There we go, getting some heat on that now. And it looks really, really nice when it's done. Swing that around, get the other side. Okay. That's a shrunken head if there ever was one. Alrighty. Now, before we put all this back into the body of the motor, let me look for my appropriate tool here. Okay, use this. I'm just gonna deburr the inside of these a little bit first. Just at the top of the brass tube, just gonna take a flat file. It's actually a half round, but it's got a flat side. I'm just gonna go on the inside of the brass tubes and deburr them a little bit. Because even though I'm using a nice pusher tool, it still sometimes will mess with the brass. And we'll stick the wires back through and get it in position and get the brush tubes back in the holders. Once again, if I wasn't doing this for the camera, they would already be in. You guys have no idea how hard it is to make it so that you can see some of what I'm doing. And I know my big fat paws are in the way. And you can't see a lot of it. And for that, I do apologize. But okay, that one started. And then push it in, and it's in. Notice the side it's on. The tab is pointing towards the side where the coil is. I'm flipping the whole mess over. lather, rinse, repeat, put the one in that goes on the other side. You know what? Yeah, that's okay. Alrighty. And once again, the trick is getting it lined up so it's going to go. And once you get it started, then it's easy. But getting it started is the part that's not so much fun. All right, get in there. There we go. I had it started. I want to get this done, this motor done today, so I can get it in the mail tomorrow. It's tomorrow. There we go. That slid in. Tomorrow, unfortunately, we have the very sad job of going to the funeral of a friend who passed unexpectedly. We went to a thing for his widow yesterday up in Morris Plains, and tomorrow is the funeral service. Anyway, here we go. We're putting the screws back in just to hold this mess together. Then we're going to test to make sure that the brushes are going to clear those brass tubes nicely. Because if not, then we're going to take the file and do a little bit more file work. So we get that in there. Let's take a brush. Try dropping a brush down the top. Oh, look at that. It went in nice and easy. Okay. So we'll extract it. Let's try a brush from the other end. And putting it in. And it goes in nice and easy and comes all the way through. So that won't be a problem. Actually, I'm going to push it through all the way and extract it from inside. I don't like putting the extra strain on the springs by yanking on them like that. Okay, so we got that much done. I got to take this over to the bench motor. I'm going to clean up this stuff with a little bit of quick drying contact cleaner first. The commutator bars, then I'm going to level them with nail files. Give me about a minute, which is going to be equivalent to about a half a second for you guys. And I'll get all this done and I'll be right back. Okay, so before I forget, I'm going to put the washer on the end here so that it's engaged where it belongs. And first thing we'll do is we'll drop the worm into the motor housing. That worm is fitting awfully tight. There we go. And we'll stick a screwdriver down the hole and get the worm pretty much lined up. Now, I'm going to put the moving mass in. Get it lined up. Ah, it's going in. Boom. And as always, we're taking the flat here on the back of the shaft. We're putting it at about the 10 o'clock position so we have an idea where the flat is. Then we'll rotate the worm so that there's a set screw in the approximate location, which is what we've got now. Oopsie. And I'm going to use a different screwdriver than that. I will feel for the flat, as it were. And you can feel it. You can feel when you hit the flat and when you don't. Yep, that's right on it. You can confirm that by putting the flat on the top. There, I'm on the flat. Okie doke. And crank that down. And then spin the shaft to get to the other screw. And crank that one in. All right, so we have that. Let's drop in our brushes. We know they're going to fit proper. And that one went right in, right where it belongs. Put a brush cap in. Once again, kids, do not crank your brush caps down unless you're planning on spending big money replacing your brush caps. You will break them. Do not break your brush caps. These old Bakelite pieces, they will shatter on you. I did recently order a couple of extra sets of brushes, and I think I ordered 6 brush caps, something like that, from the Featherweight shop. They have an aftermarket brush cap that they have made that fits perfectly, looks nice, and it's actually a lot cheaper than what the average brush cap is going for on eBay, for if you want a legitimate Singer one. Those are running anywhere between $12 and $15 each on eBay, which I think you all will agree is pretty ridiculous. Okay, so we got that back in, that's spinning freely. I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to terminate these wires in ring terminals and shrink tubing. And before we put the grease wicks in and lube this motor up, we're going to test her out first. It's like I said, I never powered this motor up when she came in. I just started taking her apart. And I started taking her apart in front of you, so you know as much about this motor as I do. So I'm grabbing some 22-18 ring terminals, which are right there. And we'll get a little bit of eighth inch tubing. That should be enough to do two. Right there. Okay. Wire strippers and crimp tool at the ready. So let's do this. I'm going to go ahead and put my shrink tubing over these first. Now you'll note, and I know I sound like a broken record, I am not Singer. I am not cheap with the wire. I don't have to be cheap with the wire. I'm not manufacturing these things. I'm not looking at it like, oh, for every inch extra that I give on each wire, that's one machine that won't come out of the spool. I don't look at it that way. I look at it, how much aggravation is it to put these things back together again. So I'm going to crimp this up. Get both ends of that crimped. Okay. And a word on crimping. I know I've mentioned it before. If you look at these crimp connectors, on the rounded end, there's the seam running through the middle. On the back, obviously, it's not. That's how these things are made. On your crimping tool, or at least this particular crimping tool, you'll note it's got a half moon and a pincher thing. I think anvil is the word I'm looking for. Anyway, what you want to do, if you're using this style crimping tool, you want to put the half moon up against the split side, so that you're pushing it in from the back and get a good crimp on it and slip over your shrink tubing. And let's get our heat. Do I have a little bit of extra sticking out of there? I'm going to just trim that off. There we go. There we go. That's trimmed. All right. Now we'll get our heat gun. Ooh, that's nice and warm. And you will shrink that down. And then bring the shrink tubing back up on that. Shrink tube it. Oh, doesn't that look pretty? Okie doke. I happen to have a power block sitting on my bench. Oh, look at that. It still has washers in it. There's no switch. This one came off of a 201-2. Switch is not there. Doesn't matter. So, we'll go ahead and put that in place. You know, God, Bob, you're an idiot. And I'm surprised that my computer's not, my camera's not yelling at me for that. God. It's 2 and 3, not 1 and 3. And I'm not going to edit that out. You're going to get to see it. So I always put the light on first. Making excuses, I know. But that's okay. The lovely and talented Elizabeth, by the way, has just gotten home from work. So I did take the opportunity to say hi to her while the camera was not rolling. Okay, and I have a foot controller here. So, let's plug this up. Plug it into the wall, and let's take a peek. See if she's spinning, and if she spins in the right direction. Oh, look at that. She spins and she spins in the correct direction. You can tell us the correct direction. Top of the gear is spinning towards the back plate. Bada bing, bada boom. We'll run her in a little bit so that the brushes get back in on the commutator, and she'll be just fine. All right. Let's finish her up. There's not a whole heck of a lot to do on this one because she didn't come in with a bobbin winder. So really just the grease wicks, and get her a good lube job, and she can go back home to Minnesota tomorrow. And this video can get posted tonight. How about them apples? I don't know if Liz has plans for me for this evening. Last night we had our quilting class, which went well enough. I did not finish my sewing project in class last night. I'm going to have to get that done sometime this coming week. And we had plenty of time to finish it in class. It's just that my eyes were shot. It's been a brutal week at the day gig. And I was like, yeah, nah. Can't focus, can't see what I'm doing. No sense making any mistakes. And I made enough mistakes and ripped out enough things and actually recut some fabric on one item. And I'm like, yeah, I'm not going to do that. And it was something simple. We were working on the flying geese last night. And it was kicking my posterior region, as it were, because my vision was shot. So I figure, discretion being the better part of valor, I will leave it alone and come back to it when I am not so bloody tired. And there was a friend of ours in class. She had just gotten back from an overseas flight. She was really tired, too. So I didn't feel so guilty about being tired. So, anyway, let's put some fresh wicks in these springs. I'll clean these springs out in just a second. I should have taken them to the sink, but I didn't. That's okay. I've got other ways of cleaning them. Get the worst of the grease off of it. There we go. All right. Oh, let's put this end cap back on first. We are literally almost there. Okay. Screw the grease wick in. Screw the grease wick in. Now, I've seen people put these into the motor dry. I don't like doing that. I like priming them first. And I've seen people put them back into the motor and try to get it back into the motor with the clip at the same time. To that, I say, no, 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 no. I do it my way. I give them a good dipping in grease. I have decanted grease from my big can because maneuvering that can around can be an inflamed hemorrhoidal tissue at times. All right, so dip it in grease. Get a good preload of grease on the end of the grease wick. Otherwise, you're just putting the wool felt against nothing. We'll go ahead and get the clip in on top of it. And I use a pair of tweezers to reposition that spring. And push the clip down. And that's gripping and everything's in. And once again, do the lather, rinse, repeat on the top. Get it in position. These clips aren't holding very well, but they're in there now. They're fine. And we'll do this one first this time. get a little dollop, pack it on there. I'm going to use a finger and press it in. Take another little dollop, put it on there, press it in, force it down with my finger. We're going to keep on packing it in like that. Oops. Don't worry, I'll clean the excess off. It's not going to go back to Minnesota all ugly. And keep on pressing it in. We're eventually going to force it so it's going to come out inside against the worm. But this comes from years of packing wheel bearings the hard way. Not exactly the way you do wheel bearings, but it's the same concept, packing grease in with your paws. Old school mechanics, what can I say? And pack that in. It's starting to come in now around the worm. You can see it start to come up. I'm going to give it a little bit more. Like I said, it's just grease. And that's plenty. So, let's wipe this excessive mounts off. Get this all cleaned up. Actually, I'm going to get the cap on and then take a swab to this area. And screwing this cap in will force more of it down into the worm area itself. Take a fresh paper towel for the next one. Okie doke. And you can see there's plenty come up around the gear. I did not get a hand wheel nor a light or anything with this one. So that's why this one's going to be such an easy job. Also, what I appreciate about this one is this one didn't come to me pre-disassembled. I don't mind fixing motors where somebody has tried and failed, but I can do it so much faster when I don't have to go searching for parts, or I don't have to try to undo another error. Well, that's more than enough. All right, wipe off some of this excess. If you've made it this far in this video, I want to thank you for watching. All the views help. Pack this in. I'm sorry it wasn't more exciting. It's just a motor rewire. I do so many of them. To me, I don't want to say boring, because some of them get pretty exciting. Some of them are pretty challenging. But this one was pretty straightforward, and it went without any problems. I don't know how long the video was running prior to the pause to go to the bench motor, but we're about a little over 16 minutes since then. So anyway, that's what I've got for you. Lori, thanks a lot for sending her in. I'm going to get her in the mail to you tomorrow. And for the rest of y'all, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.